Welcome to another TCP walkthrough video. I'm Logan, and in today's video, we're going to be going over calculating the return on investment, or ROI, for different investments. And we're going to be doing that the SuperfastCPA way, which is diving straight into questions to learn the material. If you don't know much about our strategies, make sure you go to superfastcpa.com and check out our free one-hour webinar training. We go over the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, and again, it's only 1 hour, it is free, and it will save you so much time struggling with your process. So make sure you go check that out. Also, just letting you know, we will only be going over 5 questions in this video, while SuperfastCPA members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it in the members forum. So if you like this, you can get more of it by becoming a SuperfastCPA member. With all that said, let's dive straight into the questions. Okay, here we are at question 1. Jessica is 40 years old and began contributing to a Roth IRA in 2025. She will invest $5,000 each year until she retires in 20 years. The balance of the Roth IRA is projected to be $150,000 at the date of her retirement. Ignoring tax, what is Jessica's return on investment, or ROI? Okay, if you don't really know how ROI works, that's okay. Let's dive straight into the answer to learn how this calculation works for the rest of the video. Okay, so the answer is the ROI is 50%, so let's read through this short explanation. First, you have to calculate the total amount that was invested, so that's over the 20 years, that's $5,000 times 20 equals $100,000, so $100,000 was invested, and then you take the current balance, or in this case, the projected balance, you subtract the total investment, and then using that number, you divide it by the total investment again, and multiply all of it by 100, giving you the full 50%. And again, let's walk through that one more time. So the projected balance less the actual investment, $50,000, divided by the actual investment, and then you multiply all of that by 100. Again, this is ignoring tax. So this is just kind of a brief introduction into ROI, but most of the time you do need to incorporate tax in some way. So the rest of the questions will be dealing with different aspects of ROI, including looking at taxes. So let's go to the next question. Okay, here is question 2. Linda is 35 years old and began contributing to a Roth IRA in 2023. She will invest $6,000 each year until she retires in 25 years. The balance of the Roth IRA is projected to be $200,000 at the date of her retirement. Assuming a 20% income tax rate during her working years, what is Linda's return on investment, or ROI? Okay, so the first question was really straightforward. We didn't have to incorporate tax or anything. It was just the straight investment and the projected balance. But now it's throwing in that there is a 20% income tax rate that we have to consider. It might not come very intuitively how this works. So if you want, go ahead and pause the video, see if you can think through it and figure it out. But if not, let's go ahead and go to the answer to learn how you incorporate the tax into the calculation. Okay, so the answer is only 6.67% ROI, which is not good. So let's read through this. And again, this will explain how the tax works when it comes to investing in a Roth IRA. So just a reminder, contributions to a Roth IRA are made with after-tax income. This means that the money Linda contributes is already taxed, and she will not pay taxes on qualified withdrawals during retirement. Linda invests $6,000 each year for 25 years, totaling $150,000, and this amount is her after-tax investment. Now, if you're like me, when I was going through this and kind of learning about this, to me, it sounded like that was it. That was the full investment, and I didn't need to think about the tax because Roth IRAs are after-tax investments. But let's read a little bit more. To understand the true economic cost of this investment, we consider how much pre-tax income Linda needed to earn in order to have $150,000 to invest after taxes. So given that there was a 20% tax rate, the total pre-tax income needed to result in $150,000 invested is this equation right here. You take the $150,000, divide it by 1 less the tax rate, or in this case, divide it by 0.8, and that gives you $187,500. Now, again, to think about this, for Roth IRAs, you have to invest after-tax income. But to get to that point, you have to pay taxes. So that is a built-in expense or cost of this investment. So in all reality, to be able to have this investment, this is the amount of money she had to have to be able to invest in this Roth IRA or contribute to this Roth IRA. So this is the actual real investment if you think about the total economic cost for her contributing to this Roth IRA. So you take the current balance, $200,000, or again, this is the projected balance in this case. You subtract the total pre-tax income in this case, because again, Roth IRAs use after-tax income. So we need to think about how much money it all actually costs overall. And then you divide all that by the same number again, $187,500. and that gives you only 6.67% ROI. So not a very good return on investment. And it makes sense because you look at it, she invested $150,000. She's only getting $200,000 out in the end after 25 years of investing. Obviously not a very good return on investment. In summary, while Roth IRA contributions are made with after-tax dollars, using the tax rate in the ROI calculation helps to reflect the total economic effort, considering the taxes paid on the income used for the investment. This provides a more comprehensive measure of the investment's performance, because again, you're looking at all the money that was necessary to get that investment. So make sure you pay attention to that. The first question was about a Roth IRA, but we didn't look at the tax. And in this question, it was again about a Roth IRA, but we did include the tax. So make sure you're paying attention to what the question is asking for and that you know how to deal with a Roth IRA in either circumstance. Let's go to the next few questions where instead we're going to talk about pre-tax investments. Okay, here is question three. Sarah invested $40,000 in a retirement fund 5 years ago. The fund currently has a balance of $55,000. If the return on investment, or ROI, over this period is 37.5%, what is the associated income if the income tax is 25%? Okay, so this is a little bit different. It's giving us the ROI right up front, and we need to figure out how much the income tax is for this question. So if you want, go ahead, pause the video and think through this. It's actually not too difficult, but there are some things that you might include that might throw you off. But again, when you're ready, come back. We'll look at the answer together. Okay, the answer is $3,750. So again, this one's pretty straightforward, actually. Let's read the explanation. We are given the ROI and need to calculate the total income. And we need to calculate the total income so that we can calculate the income tax. So first, we just have to calculate how much income, and that's pretty easy. You take the current balance, subtract the investment that was put in, and that gives you the income. And then you take the income and multiply it by the income tax, and that tells you how much the income tax will be on the income you earned from this investment. So again, pretty straightforward. Let's go to the next question. Okay, here is question four. A 50-year-old man invests 10% of his salary into a 401k plan for 15 years. He makes $150,000 per year. Given a return on investment of 25% without tax consideration, what is the balance of his 401k plan at his retirement at age 65? So again, another question where we're not taking into consideration the tax. This is a little bit different because this is a 401k. This is pre-tax money that we're talking about. So if you want, go ahead and pause the video based off what we've learned so far about ROI in this video. And when you're ready, come back, we'll look at the answer together. Okay, the answer is $281,250. So let's go through this calculation again. So first, we have to figure out the total investment, which is his annual salary multiplied by the percentage he's going to invest. And then you multiply all that by the number of years he's been investing. So pretty easy, $150,000 multiplied by 10% and multiply that by 15 years and he invested $225,000. So to figure out the balance at retirement, again, we already have the ROI in this case. So we take the total investment, which was $225,000, and then we add the investment multiplied by the ROI, which again is the return on the investment, which in this case is 25%. So we take $225,000 plus $56,250, giving us $281,250. So we can see pretty easily that a lower ROI isn't as good as a higher ROI. Basically, a 100% ROI means you doubled your investment. You got your investment back all the way. And anything above 100% means that you're just getting a ton extra. So we can figure out what the balance will be at retirement. Just another way of looking at ROI. Let's go to the next question. Okay, here we are at question five, another 401k plan. What is the amount of the 401k distribution net of tax if the ROI before tax is 120%? The employee contributes $7,500 a year for 25 years until the employee retires, and the employee takes a lump sum distribution amount at retirement with a tax rate of 25%. Again, this is a 401k, not a Roth IRA, so there is tax at distribution, unlike with a Roth IRA where we take into consideration the tax at the beginning. So if you want to think through this and do the calculation based off what we've learned, that's great. And when you're ready, come back, we'll look at it together. All right, and the answer is C, $309,375. So again, let's read through this explanation. An investment in a 401k is made with pre-tax dollars. I said that before. The investment has tax-deferred growth with no taxes levied on dividends or capital gains until distribution. So here's the step-by-step calculation. First, we have to calculate the total investment, which again is that annual contribution multiplied by the number of years. So that's $187,500. Then he did take a lump sum distribution, which before taxes, with an ROI of 120%, means he has the total investment plus his investment multiplied by 120%. So we add that all together, and that gives us $412,500. And that's pretty great. But since this was a lump sum distribution, we have to take into consideration the tax that was paid on this lump sum distribution. So we take the distribution multiplied by 1 less the tax rate, and that gives us $309,375. All right, we've looked at ROI in a whole bunch of different circumstances, and you can either calculate the ROI or you can use the ROI to figure out other things like what the total tax is going to be if there's a lump sum distribution in this case, or what the ending retirement balance will be, or different things like that. And we also looked at Roth IRAs, which are post-tax investments, and we looked at 401ks, which are pre-tax investments. So kind of the two different situations that you're going to be dealing with when you look at investment options and ROI. Before we go any further, let's do one more part of the process called pillar topics. Now, the idea behind pillar topics is as you're going through the material, you will notice the things that keep popping up, the things that are obviously important because you've seen them in like 3, 4, 5 questions throughout your studying that morning. For example, Roth IRAs or 401ks, you've seen multiple questions on both of them when it comes to ROI. So you take a second and you write down those pillar topics so that you know them for later and for the exam. So let's go ahead and look at the pillar topics for this video. All right, here are the pillar topics. And again, you would write these down yourself, so you might have different pillar topics than I would, but these are the pillar topics that I have here. So first off, calculating ROI for retirement investments. To calculate the return on investment for retirement accounts, we subtract the total amount invested from the final balance, and then we divide all of that by the total amount invested, and we multiply it by 100, and that gives us the ROI. Also, to accurately measure the return on investment for a Roth IRA, it's important to consider the total pre-tax income needed to make the contributions. This was something that I thought was confusing at first, so I figured it was a good pillar topic. This provides a more comprehensive view of the investment's true cost, because again, you have to think not only are you investing that money, you had to pay taxes to be able to invest that money in the Roth IRA. So there was that cost upfront as well. Also, the total amount invested in a retirement account can be calculated by multiplying the annual contribution by the number of years of contribution. Pretty straightforward. And finally, this one's a pretty straightforward one. A higher ROI indicates a more profitable investment. And that makes sense. That means you're getting more back from your investment, a higher return. Pretty easy pillar topics in this video. Thank you for watching. Be sure to go check out our free 1-hour webinar training on superfastcpa.com. Again, we teach the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam. It's something you don't want to miss. Also, if you liked going through these 5 questions in this video, just remember that SuperfastCPA members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it in the members forum. So if you like this, you can get more of it and more practice by becoming a SuperfastCPA member. If you liked the video, make sure to like it and leave a comment. I hope this was helpful, and I will see you in the next video.